What industry is shadier than most people realize? Umbrella manufacturing. The fitness supplement industry. A bunch of new supplements daily with proprietary blends that don't need to be FDA approved with false claims all over the labeling. You have a bunch of fake reviews on Amazon or all over their business website with a bunch of shoddy science and people buy into them to get fit quick. The wedding industrial complex. So much price gouging. After reading through this thread, I'm inclined to believe the answer is every industry. The aged care industry, especially the private sector, there is a lot more neglect than people realize. The funeral industry, from the cost of coffins to monuments, obits to flowers to cemetery plots, grave openings, grave closings, there's a great deal of markup and charges built into the entire funeral expense. People are often surprised by total outlay, and how they sometimes pay for things not really needed, but included in the overall bill. The olive oil industry. Olive oil is one of the most adulterated products in the world, to the point that most of the extra virgin oil you buy does not actually adhere to international guidelines, and some can be classified as lampant grade, literally, lamp oil in Italian. Edit, lampant does not mean lamp oil, it means clear, visible, glaring, but is referring to earlier use of poor grade oil in lamps. Thank you, you rockabut and you stigmat. The K-pop industry. The girls are literally used as prostitutes among music producers, record label execs and advertising CEOs. Such a corrupt and disgusting industry. Edit, wow. This really upsets some hardcore pop fans that can't fathom the idea that their beloved pop isn't as pure as they're led to believe, although it's not exactly like they're hiding it. Mattresses industry. Price rigging leads to several 100% price increase. Game development. Devs are extremely overworked, expected to work 60-80 hours weeks, depending on the company, without additional pay, to meet unrealistic deadlines. How has nobody said Hollywood yet? One of the biggest open secrets is the rampant pedophilia going on in Hollywood. Family Guy, to my surprise, recently called this problem out and singled out Bryan Singer specifically. For those interested, Corey Feldman has been very vocal about the issue over the years. An Open Secret is also a documentary about Hollywood's pedophile problem. The school textbook industry. They come out with a new edition every 2 years and most of the time they don't change a thing. But the universities are all on board and make it a requirement for professors to use the most updated books. International sport. Match fixing. Links to organized crime. Drug cheating. Corruption. The more money invested in a sport, the higher the likelihood of shady it going on. Most people have their head in the sand over it because they're so passionate about their particular sports. Corporate dentistry. Aspen Dental in particular. They only hire chicks with big tits. And they try to get every ducking patient on an antibiotic treatment because of deteriorating jaw bones. They do this by screwing with the digital x-ray data. So instead of showing a grayscale, it show a black or white image. The result is, it shows a jagged line where the cutoff point for black or white would be. They show you the jagged line and let you believe that's your actual jawbone eroding away. So, of course you sign up for their $4,700 treatment plan. Lying Methodicas, run by a bunch of guys from India. 2. Footnote. I couldn't believe the response on this, let alone the number of people who got taken by them. The only course of action is to get it on paper, their treatment plan. Anything they'll let loose of, get a second opinion from a reputable dentist, or two or three, and send copies of everything to your city-state's attorney general's office, a Better Business Bureau and whoever else sounds good. With all of what I'm seeing on here, the only reason they're still in business is that no one's bothered to complain. Complain. People. It is the squeaky wheel that gets the grease. Plus, in a similar vein, Dateline had a truly unbelievable story on yesterday of an oncologist, cancer doctor, who was telling people that did not have cancer, that they did, and was putting them on chemotherapy just to line his pockets. His clinic had the x-ray equipment, the blood testing equipment and the chemo rooms, to keep it all in-house, so no one would know. He raked in millions. All those treated got poisoned, and some died. Gemstones, X, diamonds. Many people know they are overpriced, but a lot of people don't realize how they end up on those rings, necklaces, etc. You can try to explain it to people, but then they think you're being a cheap bastard by refusing to purchase something like diamonds. Edit. Some people were asking the story behind this, so here you go. Synopsis. Slave labor. Child labor. Barbaric punishments for workers and slaves who don't meet quotas or steal. Supporting war and conflict. Supporting oppressive regimes. Environmental hazards. Creating artificial scarcity. And so on. Most people also think it is just diamonds, but other gemstones support the things above. Rubies from Myanmar, formerly Burma, are a big one. Comma. Some links below. Blood diamonds. This is the documentary, not the film, starring DiCaprio, Connolly, and Hounsou. Blood diamond. Wikipedia article on conflict diamonds. Color gemstone mining. Gemstone mining practices. We all know the music industry is already pretty shady, but there are some things that even go beyond what they normally do. If you want to have an idea of what I'm talking about, look into the situation with $KHA. Edit. This link provides some good info. Breast cancer awareness. Especially big ones like Susan G. Komen. The eyeglasses sunglasses industry is largely monopolized by one company, Luxottica. They own manufacture over 70% of the eyewear brands worldwide, including Ray-Ban, Oakley, Chanel, Prada, Giorgio Armani, Burberry, Versace, and Dolce & Gabbana. Not only do they own manufacture all these brands, but they also monopolize the eyewear retail industry. They own Lens Crafters, Sunglass Hut, Pearle Vision, Sears Optical, Target Optical, IMED Vision Care Plan, and Glasses.com. They have few competitors in eyewear brands. The only big competitors they have in the retail world are Walmart and Costco in the US. Oil field supply companies. Everyone is making millions. So this bolt is now $50. Oil crashes. Everyone is losing their ass. So this bolt is now 49.99. The insane profit margins in the oil field supply chain industry pretty much nullifies the pay for quality argument. This thread is so depressing. The corn industry. It's in everything. High fructose corn syrup. As a replacement for sugar because of government substandards. We feed the livestock with corn. And they even try to run cars off of it with E85, which is a net loss of energy from growing to processing, shipping, then ineffectively running your 3-ton truck. I also understand entropy. I love my 08 Evo. Zoom zoom. There is not a single defense worth crediting. Medicine. Research. I am not talking about it being a huge conspiracy trying to make us ill in order to earn more cash. I actually am a pro-medical research person and I am also working in that field. But there are a lot of publications coming up every year, which are a big pile of hodget, as they either intend to prove what they want to prove and or are driven by industrial demands, or they blow big headlines followed by terrible scientific methods, just to be recognized or publicated by prestigious journals. Edit. I ain't native English. The towing industry. Whether right or wrong, when they get a call they have to tow. Police protect them because they make it so there's nothing needed to be done by the police. Oh, and our normal business hours are Monday through Friday the 8th of May, so any time you would actually get towed is a $400 after hour fee. Plus it destroys your car to get pulled along while in a parked state. End note. Yes, I am salty about being towed, as there was no legitimate reason for me to be towed. But once it happened, it unraveled how illegitimate that industry is for being considered completely legitimate. Haha. Every ducking industry is shadier than most people realize. Varsity. The company that holds a national monopoly on school cheerleading supplies and competitions. If you have a daughter that's competing in intramural cheerleading competitions from middle school on up, parents have to pay out the nose for official varsity outfits and supplies, or they cannot compete in the events. Dues have to be paid to varsity for a myriad of ridiculous things. If their team is judged to win the intramural competitions, they can go to nationals, which is a complete scam. There's more national competitions that varsity makes money from than there are states in the country. Then there's safety. Did you know that more cheerleaders go to the hospital for injuries than football players? Cheerleading isn't considered a sport. Varsity wants to keep it that way, because if it were considered a sport, there would have to be one state championship per state and one national championship, ensuring varsity would make less money. Also, with sports comes oversight and sport safety. Having enough spotters would be scrutinized and some types of dangerous activities might be banned in competition. TLDR. If you have a daughter interested in becoming a cheerleader, Varsity Incorporated owns every single aspect of it from start to finish, squeezes as much money out of your wallet as possible, and compromises safety to make more money. Edit. I first found out about Varsity because of an episode on cheerleading in season 8 of Penn and Teller's show Bullet. I recommend watching it. I'm glad I know about the racket before my daughter is in school. Private education, especially for your kids. We're a business first, school second. If your kid's enrolled on extra courses through a school, try to talk to the teacher directly rather than through a progress advisor or WE. These are salespeople interested in keeping cash flow incoming. Us teachers are told the same thing. But most of us do care more about your kid than the company's bottom line. Edit. I'm talking specifically about additional schooling and courses. Evening classes etc. I wasn't referring to the accredited network of private primary secondary schools, though I'm sure there's a decent bit of shadiness possible there as well. Apparently caterers and their bullet decaf coffee. By far, the livestock or meat industry. Forget the happy cow in a field thing. It's as shady as it can get, in all aspects. Internet porn. A company called MindGeek owns all or almost all of the popular porn sites. Their monopoly means they can duck over both consumers and porn stars. Edit. To clarify, A. The free porn is basically an advertisement for the paid subscriptions and B. It's those subscriptions where the consumer gets ducked. The spa industry, massage therapy, skin therapy, etc. Though I think people already believe it can be shady, but they don't realize how common it is regardless of the area and clientele. Even though we are regulated and a corporate chain, you will have clients coming in and taunting the therapist with $100 bills near their genitals. Even the nicest of places have scum like this. Sorry guys. Happy endings aren't what they used to be, and therapists are getting fired and lawsuits filed against them left and right if they do anything seemingly wrong. It's disgusting. Source: I work at the front desk and hear the most absurd stories from some of my co-workers. The prison industry. They make sure lawmakers keep their prisons overflowing with people by passing or maintaining laws or systems that make it easy to put the poor in jail. I'm surprised no one has said the cell phone industry. The price gouging is ridiculous. From services to devices to accessories. I worked in a Verizon retailer for a bit under a year, and they encouraged making people pay much more than they needed for phones they could have gotten at half the price. And we had to throw in accessories that the customers ended up paying for anyways. Jail phone calls. They are ridiculously expensive. I work in a similar industry, so don't judge. High-end audio. Honestly, there's more snake oil bullet and hi-fi than any other market I can think of. Appliance manufacturers and various filters for appliances. You do not need a $50 plus water filter every 6 months. There is nothing a 2-inch square air filter in your fridge can accomplish. The lights that come on to tell you it's time to replace your filter are timed. They do not measure anything. The light will go off every 6 months whether you ever run a drop of water through the filter. If you happen to have water that needs filtration, the filters will last over a year easily. Academia is ducked for real. Academic nepotism. Made up results. Cutthroat tactics to keep new minds from infiltrating. I left it and went oil. Academia is shadier by far. Door-to-door residential security alarm sales. I was a rep for a year before I decided I couldn't go on lying to people day after day just so I could pay my own bills. Pull up a chair. Or if you're at work, head to the can. And let me tell you a story about an industry that preys on everyone involved. The employees. The customers. I've even heard of suppliers being mistreated, but I won't go into that because I never saw it myself. A couple of years ago, I was getting close to finishing up college. I had taken the year before off to work a full-time outside sales job selling internet services to business for a well-known US ISP. they had given me decent sales training and prepped me to be successful if I worked hard enough. I did fairly well with them and thought of myself as a good salesman. And I still do. After 10 months I'd made enough money and went back to college to finish my last year. Eventually I began to run out of money because I partied a bit much and began looking for another job. One of my friends told me about how he had a great summer in Florida making a couple $1,000s a week selling security systems. If I made a couple sales a day I could even make $10,000 or more a week. It was all up to how hard I wanted to work. My manager gave me the same song and dance and before you know it I had a hat, a shirt, a clipboard full of paperwork. And I hit the streets with no idea about what I was doing. Unlike business internet sales, there was no training here. When I'd gone a week without selling anything, I asked my manager to teach me what to do, say, and how to be successful. He gave me the company workbook, a couple DVDs to watch, and a pat on the back. With my newfound education, I set off and successfully completed another week of zero sales. This time I got my manager to take me out and show me what he does and what he says. I spent the afternoon listening to my manager lie to elderly people, stay-at-home moms, people with questionable intelligence, and many more types of people that had crumbling homes and lives. I also watched my manager make $2,800 that afternoon, of which he gave me $400 just for being there. That $400 paid my rent that month. I was hooked. Never mind the questionably immoral part about conning people that couldn't afford anything nice into a 42-month contract of $68.99. I was going to be able to provide for myself doing what my manager did. Fast forward 2 months and 11 sales and I got on a plane in Atlanta leaving for Tucson, Arizona in late May. My team had been selected to spend a sunny and warm summer in southern Arizona. If you've never been there, Tucson and Yuma regularly gets up to 125 degrees Fahrenheit during the day in the summer. Because it's so hot. Nobody wants to open their doors either. Especially not to a door-to-door salesman. I was taught to knock a door and stand back about 8 feet and slightly sideways so that I appeared non-threatening. People occasionally would open their doors and then I'd introduce myself, my company, tell them that I was the regional marketing manager and that their home had been selected because of where it was in relation to whatever I wanted to make up, and they were to receive a free home security system. Free. Yes, ma'am. You heard me right, a free brand spanking new alarm system for you to help us get the word out about protecting the neighborhood. Because I'm sure you know about all the break-ins happening lately, right? Yes. Great. Blah. Blah. Blah on and on I'd go asking leading questions and lying about anything that I couldn't be truthful about if it meant that I'd end up not getting the sale. Hours upon hours I spent knocking doors and went home with about 3 sales a week when I was doing my best. The longer I spent my time in Arizona, the louder my conscience began to scream. To make matters worse, when I would go home in the evenings, it was to a 2-bedroom apartment that I had to share with 8 other guys. There were 5 more apartments just like mine spread out throughout an apartment complex in northwest Tucson. I had no privacy, and barely anywhere comfortable to sleep. I'm glad that the downstairs neighbors were more employees of our company because otherwise they would have complained about the noise and alcohol smell. The 8 other guys I shared an apartment with were all guys I went to college with. However, I didn't know any of them before we all arrived. We were all sophomores or older and most of us were fairly smart. We all came from middle-class families with traditional WASP roots. Most importantly, every single one of us had been given the same training. Pick a spiel, tell your lies, and come home with signed contracts, or you're fired, kicked out of company housing, and on your own to get home to GA. Day after day we all did this. 6 days a week from 12 PM to 9 to 10 PM hopped up on energy drinks and drinking a gallon of water apiece per day to not die of dehydration. There was actually even a guy that invented a pitch based on him appearing as if he was about to pass out just to be let inside someone's house so he could deliver his pitch where it was cool. Eventually the numbers in my apartment dwindled, as did our sales. The real kicker about corporate housing is that we were told it would be free as long as we were selling regularly. We should have known that our free housing was just as free as the free alarm systems we were slinging to people at the tune of near $70 a month for them to use. For someone that made a couple sales a day, this was no problem. For for someone that made a sale every 2 weeks. Funds got real tight, especially since half or more of your paycheck would be taken out to pay your rent to the company. After 3 weeks, there were only 3 of us still in my apartment and none of us were selling much. At the beginning of July, our managers decided that we needed a change of scenery, so we moved to Yuma, Arizona. Yuma borders Mexico. Dust is the primary cash crop, and crime is the primary profession. I kid you not, the mascot for Yuma hires the criminals. Look it up. It would have been a great place to sell security systems to if the population was rich drug dealers and the crimes weren't all petty theft. Instead, there was lots of murder, auto theft, and vandalism, none of which can be stopped by a home security system. On top of that, the people that live there are mostly poor and can't afford to spend an extra $50 to $70 a month on anything that isn't food or staying cool. My time there was spent mostly in Somerton, AZ, where I had to learn to speak Spanish to try to get sales. I made no sales, but I did meet some amazing people that fed me and invited me into their homes to share meals and rest when the sun would start to go down. I think those wonderful people are the only real reason I didn't go hungry during much of that July. I was far too proud to admit to my parents that I was broke and needed for them to fly me home. My manager, who had tossed me $400 to entice me to sell with him in the beginning, was nowhere near as generous anymore and wouldn't even buy me a sandwich the only time I got ballsy enough to ask. The thing I did ask for regularly was to work in better neighborhoods, pitching to people who could actually afford our product. That request was consistently denied. I could go on and on about how our installers would come and literally rip systems out of people's walls that got buyer's remorse. Or about the times I was held up at gunpoint or threatened by gangs during my summer selling alarms. But the fact of it is, those things didn't mess with me as much as what I was primarily asked to do. I was asked to lie and be good at it and do it often, all for the sake of a company making $1 billion while its workers starved and died on the inside. Last thing, that summer I nearly lost my apartment, my car, I lost several friends, and I lost a lot of my soul. Pieces of my soul are still installed in people's houses all over southern Arizona, just waiting to be thrown out when a more convincing lie comes along. The moral of the story is this: if you're ever asked to do a job and it doesn't feel right, go with your gut and don't take the job. That's all the time I have to write for now. If you have any specific questions besides the name of the company I worked for, ask away. Large, more than 200k subs, YouTube stars. I recently worked for a YouTuber, and quickly realized he, being somewhat ethical, was in the vast minority. My task for him was to develop a Minecraft server, which is actually a lot more profitable than it seems. However, I met several other YouTubers, many of which were not primarily focused in Minecraft, and several of which were somewhat off. At the end of the project, I had met 2 pedophiles, several people with serious mental health problems. I really enjoyed the project, but I did get paid $200 per month with occasionally upwards of 60 hours work weeks. I'm currently 17, was 16. In all honesty, that was my choice, but I do question the ethical implications of it now. Also, seeing as the entire target audience of a Minecraft server is kids, I often questioned the ethics around this. Anyways, this was not my primary point. All kinds of crazy it happens on YouTube. People manipulate others almost constantly, and even large networks such as Machinima have been known to generate unescapable and unfair contracts. If you want to succeed in the YouTube world, you are pretty much required to throw others under the bus. The number of times I've seen this happen is far more than I can count, and it often happens for seemingly no provocation. Want to record a video with someone? You'd better cut any ties with anyone they dislike. Many, if not all, large YouTubers are dealing with insane amounts of stress due to what the job entails. Edit. AMA. 6,000 plus comments and we don't realize the industry isn't the variable? People are shady. The more influence a person or groups have over any industry, the shadier it will get. The fashion industry is definitely up there. Illustration. People assume freelance means free, as in they don't have to pay you. Also, despite having 80% female graduates in illustration graphic design in most universities, any in-agency jobs are male-dominated, with 80% of signees male. It's all very shady. IIT Coca-Cola Company has been one of the largest destabilizer of developing countries in the 20th century to eke out more profit. Goodwill Industries. I worked for them for about a year and was shocked at how ducked up the entire company is. The dairy industry. So much lobbying. So many dietary nutrition lies. Not to mention how poor the conditions are that most of the animals live in. Healthcare and pharmaceutical industry. The prices of healthcare services and pharmaceutical drugs are grossly inflated in the US. Try calling a hospital and try to find out how much a procedure will cost if you want to just pay for it out of pocket. It's almost impossible to get the info and they'll have you transferred to a dozen different departments because they want to charge your insurance directly. It's all a huge scam. For example, an MRI in the US will cost around $2,000 to $3,500, whereas the same procedure would cost $100 to $200 overseas. Same goes for prescription drugs. Just a huge scam. In the scuba dive industry, it is fairly common, in certain areas, Asia I'm looking at you, to have people work without contracts, without proper working residence visa and other paperwork. A lot of the customers don't know this. And they are usually shocked to hear that working 7 days week 10-12 HRS day is not unheard of. Doctor here. All the bullet cleanse and detox diets. Your body has its own built-in detoxification system. It's called your kidneys and liver. Also, all the gluten-free, soy-free, dairy-free, non-MSG etc. is all a gimmick. Unless you are actually allergic to it, it is merely another food. Not eating it won't do anything and will not make you any healthier. Rather than pay for expensive hocus pocus powders, if you exert a little self-control and limit your intake of food, sugary beverages, which most of these detox diets, skinny teas, require, they just make it easier and providing you a preset diet, you will accomplish the same thing. If you need the support and don't have the self-control, then go buy the expensive marketing. If you want to speed the process along, exercise. Chiropractors. 20/20 did a hidden camera piece years ago where they took totally healthy people, adults and children, and sent them to various chiropractors saying they just wanted a checkup. None of them said you're healthy, just keep an eye on things. They gave them all diagnoses that were all over the place. The chiropractors recommended treatment that was everything from bi-weekly appointments going forward, to saying that a perfectly healthy little girl wear a back brace for a year. I know that many people swear by them, but at the same time I have never heard of a chiropractor curing anyone of back pain. They always tell you you have to keep coming back again and again. I'm not saying there aren't some good and honest ones, but as a whole it is absolutely shady profession, and most of the help they give can be achieved by a good massage and there is no need for $180 bi-weekly appointments. It is classified as alternative medicine and the fact that they go to school for 3 to 4 years and ask to be called doctor is an insult to all PhD holders and physician everywhere. Banking. It is far shadier than most people realize. The numerous beachwear shops, waves, eagles, etc. of Myrtle Beach, South Carolina are used to wire money overseas to drug cartels and terrorist and other criminal organizations and it's perfectly legal and unregulated due to SC law. If you've ever been to Myrtle Beach, it doesn't take a genius to realize that all these shops can't stay open on sales of t-shirts, swimsuits, beach towels etc. When I say there are two or three on every corner, I am not exaggerating. Edit, linked article on it.